Hello guys, today I would like to share with you three bad coding habits that I think every programmer should avoid and stop doing in order to program better software applications in terms of maintainability and code quality. So the first bad coding habit is giving meaningless or misleading names for identifiers, variables, classes, interfaces, whatever has a name in a program. Say if you want to create a variable that holds the total amount of an order. So the best name for that variable is order total or total amount, not XYZ or something else. The variable name itself should be descriptive, self-explanatory, and detailed enough to distinguish itself from other names in a program. Similarly, if you want to implement a method that calculates the total amount of an order, so the best name for that method is calculate total amount or calculate order total, not full bar or something else. The method name should be self-explanatory and you don't have to write any comment just to explain the name of a method. And likewise, if you want to code a class that processes credit card payment, so the best name for that class is credit card payment or credit card processor, not something else. And the class name should be self-explanatory and you don't have to write any comment just to explain the name of a class. So let's stop doing the bad coding habit of giving meaningless or misleading names to every identifier you create in your program. Local variables, instance variables, methods, classes, interfaces, whatever has name in the program. Why? Why is good naming so important? Because it's for the readability of the code. The more readable the code is, the easier it is to maintain the code in the future. And remember that you write code for a human to understand, not for a computer to understand. Computer understands just zeros and ones, bits and bytes. Computer doesn't need to have meaningful or self-explanatory names. Only human needs for that. So at least you should write code that is readable for yourself now and future. Imagine that today you write code that you will come back to maintain a few months later. And if today you don't use good naming, then a few months later you might not understand what you code today. And that definitely increases the cost of maintenance of the software project. And to a lesser extent, you are working in a team with other programmers, so the readable code will help the teammates significantly. If we understand, if you had to read others' code, and I think your teammate will thank you a lot for the readable code. So stop using bad names for identifiers in your code. Instead, developing the good habit of using meaningful and self-explanatory names. A simple rule which you can use to give a good name for an identifier is that if you have to write a comment just to explain the purpose of the identifier, that means you need to rename it until you don't need to use any comments. The name should be self-explanatory. And the second bad coding habit you should stop doing now is writing long lines of code. A line of code is considered to be long if it contains more than 80 characters, more or less. The reason is that our eyes will get tired quickly if they have to read long lines for a long time and frequently. Let's take a look at this magazine, for example. You can see the text in this article is organized in two columns, so that eases our eyes for reading. Also, computers are now having wide screen making long lines visible. It's still a good habit to write short lines of code less than 80 characters for the readability and maintainability of the software project. If a line contains more than 80 characters, then you should break it into two lines and continue the code in the next line. So I think your teammate will thank you a lot for the clean code. So let's stop doing the bad habit of writing long lines of code. Instead, developing the good habit of writing short lines both for your own eyes, for your teammates' eyes, and for the readability and maintainability of the software project. And the third bad coding habit I think you should stop doing is writing too many lines of code in a method or in a class. In other words, having a big fat method or class is also for the sake of readability and maintainability of the code. And you know, our eyes, we get tired when they have to read a method or a class that contains too many lines of code. And so we are our brain. And there's no strict rule about how many lines of code you should have in a method or in a class, but keep it as short as possible. For example, I tend to write a method that contains no more than 30 lines of code. If it exceeds that number, I will split the method into two smaller ones, of course, with meaningful name for the new method. So when a method or a class gets big and fat, that means it is a time to refactor the code for more readability, breaking a fat method into smaller ones, breaking a fat class into smaller ones. So let's stop the habit of coding big and fat classes and methods. Instead, developing the good habit of writing reasonably small methods and classes. And I think everyone will benefit from this good habit. Okay, so far I have shared with you guys the three bad coding habits that you should stop doing now, that are using bad naming for identifiers, writing long lines of code, writing big and fat methods and classes. Remember that you write code that is understandable and readable for human, for yourself first, and then for your teammates, for your boss, whoever ends up maintaining the code later. Any comments are welcome. Please subscribe to my channel. Like, comment, and share this video. Thanks for watching. Until next time.